Hi guys, it's Philip English, IREX 2019. We're at another stand and we've got a gentleman here who's going to introduce himself and tell us a little bit more about his robot called Ugo. Is that right,
yes,
Ugo?
Ugo.
Okay. Okay, so what's your name, sir?
I'm Kim.
Kim.
CEO of Mira Robotics.
So the CEO?
Yes.
Wow, okay. And Ugo is the first product from the company?
Yes, exactly.
All right, perfect. And then, so, I can see we have two different robots here. So we have one that folds up laundry, and that's more of a manual robot, is that right?
Yes, but basically same robot, same avatar robot. Right. Avatar robot is a teleoperating robot. So you can control by this kind of a VR controller.
Okay.
And you can control arm, and also you can move the robot, and also you can change the height of the
Right, okay.
Body.
And then, and is it a 3D printed robot? Is
yes,
that right?
Actually we are doing prototyping, so not in mass production.
Right, okay. So in mass production you'd use more of a harder material.
Yes,
but for prototypes. Okay. So this one is obviously for fold cleaning, this one's for security.
Yes.
And is the idea to create a variable mount of robots that basically do a different amount of tasks, is that right?
Yes, exactly.
Okay. So where do you see, what's the sort of problems that the robots fix? Is it because there's not enough labor? So
yes,
this is for security.
As you know, Japanese population is decreased, and also for especially in service market, like bill maintenance, like a security person, and also clean stuff, is very limited resource. So we provide such a partner robot co-working with a human.
Yeah.
So we want to solve such a human resource issues.
I see. So the main problem is that obviously there's a lack of a workforce. So the idea is to create these robots that can do a whole mixture of different tasks, and then one could be security, one could be fold cleaning, but then it's just more and more and more tasks.
Yes, exactly.
Right, I see. So that's the solution of the actual robots. And then are they autonomous or is it just manual right at the moment?
Actually, we use a hybrid model, autonomous and also remote control.
Okay, yeah, so like the teleportation thing.
Yes, exactly.
Yeah. Okay. And then for the, I guess the idea is that to become more and more autonomous.
Yes, exactly.
As a product.
So robot can learn from every day's doing tasks.
Okay. And then I quite like the height thing, so that's very smart. So we can pick up something from the floor, and then it can go up to quite high,
Yes, exactly.
I really, really like that. So how far are you away from a mass-produced product?
So we plan to sell this robot in next year.
Next year,
so maybe
yeah.
During next year we will produce some mass production.
Right. So 2020. Okay, and then do you think in 5 years' time that you'll start selling? Obviously, you'll start. You start next year, but in 5 years you have more applications, more things.
Yes,
What about the grippers? Are you going to stick with that gripper, or are you going to change those? Or?
Yes, actually, this hand robot can exchange by themselves.
Ah, right.
So,
okay.
Yes. So maybe some hand is specialized for such a task.
Okay.
Especially tasks.
Do you think that they'll be able to, if you change the hand, then do you think they'll be able to cook food as well,
Maybe. It's possible, I think.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. That's great. And obviously it's mobile as well, so it can move around.
Exactly.
Is the idea to have an autonomous mobile thing as well?
Yes.
Yeah.
Autonomous mobile.
Wow, okay.
Using SLAM.
SLAM technology, yes. Okay. And you guys are based in Tokyo?
Based in Kanagawa.
Kanagawa. Oh, it's just one of the
Next to Tokyo.
Next to Tokyo. Right, it's a great. Yeah, I think it's a great product. I think it's got a lot. It's got a lot of potential, especially in all the different fields.
Thank you so much.
Right. So thanks, guys. Yeah. So that's obviously a very good overview of the Ugo robot. So thank you very much for your time.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Cool.